Hi, welcome back to Flutter State Management. From code to start with Mohammed Fathi, we are still talking about the provider state management approach. So in the last lecture, we have created the counter app using the state management provider approach. For example, let me open the emulator. When you click on this button on the increment, it's gonna increase the state, and it will be updated the consumer. We have two text here to update the text. We can use the consumer, and we have talked about the consumer. When you click on this, it's gonna update the, we have two consumer with the text, and the button itself is a consumer because he increased the state. So when you click the state, the increase will be happened and update the UI. We have talked about three main component in the provider package. We have talked about the change notifier component, and these three main components. The first one is called the change notifier, and the second one change notifier provider, and the third one is called the consumer. The first one, when you mark your class as a change notifier, you can mark it with extends or with using the mixing. So when you mark your class as a change notifier, this means now your class can be subscribable or can be subscribed by any other widget. So here many classes can listen to your class state, and when this state change, it will be this class will be notified other classes that the state here is changed. So they can update the UI. So the second one, or the second component, is called the change notifier provider. So the change notifier provider provide an instance of the change notifier to the child, to all child widgets. So for example, if you have here, so if you have an instance, for example, let me, so you have a counter here, and for example, if you need to this widget, you have a plus button here, and when you click this button, you need to update this widget. So we have two widgets here. When you click in this button, it's gonna show the counter in this widget. So where to put the change notifier? The change notifier will provide an instance of the your model or your change provider class. So this class will provide us or provide our instance with this instance of the change notifier. And the consumer here, for example, you can mark this consumer. It will be notifiable when the data changes here. For example, when the data now it's one, it will be notified the data it changes, and it can show here number one. When this change, for example, two, it will be notified and it can be updated to two. So where to put the change notifier? The change notifier will be above, for example, if you have two widgets here, and these two widgets need to access the change notifier. So we can put the change notifier provider above these two widgets. So you can, this is a widget, you can wrap this widget. So let me draw. You can wrap this widget with a change notifier provider. So where to put the change notifier provider? Above the widget that you need to access the change notifier. So we can put it here. So in our example here, we are trying to put the counter. So we have the change notifier provider here in the body. So if you try now to put the counter result in the upper, so let me here I'm gonna try to put the counter here. So I'm gonna wrap this with the consumer provider. So let me copy this consumer here. I'm gonna copy this and put it instead of this text here. So I'm gonna provide this, but this not work because the instance, this instance is not available here. So try to make this. If you try to run now, it not work because we need to make this instance from the my counter available also here, but this only available underneath the widget, these widgets. It's only available, it can be accessible from any other widget under the, for example, center. It can be available inside the center column. So it only available here. So now if you try to run it, make an error here. So to make this work, we need to put the change provider above this here. So this we need to access inside this. So this inside the upper. So we need to the parent of upper is the scaffold. So we can here cut the scaffold. Let me first make this center. I'm gonna cut and put it here. So I'm gonna cut the center widget. So this is the best the beginning of the center, and this is the end. I'm gonna cut this and remove the change notifier and replace this with our center here, and I'm gonna put the semicolon. So let me the semicolon here. The yes, we need a comma here. So this is the end of the and here the end of the scaffold. So the end of the scaffold, the return scaffold, we need to put T, remove this. So now it's work. So we can go here. Now the body is a center. So now we need to make the instance of the my counter available inside any widget inside the scaffold. So I'm gonna cut the scaffold from here. Gonna cut all the scaffold. So this is the scaffold, and instead of the scaffold, I'm gonna provide the with a widget of a change notifier provider. So here the first, I'm gonna provide. Let me make a semicolon here. The create will, so this will also will be work on an instance. The generic type will be of type my counter. So here I'm gonna, this will be anonymous function that will take a context and it return an instance of the my counter. So and inside the child, so the child will be the our scaffold. So here the child will be our scaffold. So here the child will be our scaffold. So now we can access inside the scaffold, we can access any widget inside our scaffold. Can access the my counter instance, or it can access a change notifier. So it can access this class my counter, because my counter now is an instance of a change notifier. So it can be notified when the my counter data changes. So let me restart the app. And when you open now, when you click on this plus here, it's gonna update it inside three places here. So this is work fine. So you can take a task to work on. We can work on this task in the next lecture. The task is we need to create another screen. So let me inside the upper here. I'm gonna provide the action, and here we have actions action button. So this is the action button. When you click this, we need to open a new screen. So let me create the new screen here. I'm gonna create a new screen called, for example, second dot dart. Inside this will be a stateless widget called second. Let me import the material the dart, and this will be show the scaffold and the scaffold here we gonna display the upper. The upper will be upper of type upper widget. The title will be a text. So here I'm gonna print or display, for example, Flutter. provider lesson 3 and also we need to display the counter result here, the counter result. So here the counter result, for example, we need to result or counter. You can, for example, let me remove this and make here result is, and for example, 3, the result of the counter app. Also, we need to put the result also inside the body and inside the center widget. We need to, the child will be of type text. Text widget, and also we need to show the result here. So we need to show the result in a second screen in two places, the title bar or the app bar and inside the body. So now the result of this data, counter data, will be available in two 5 places. In the main screen, it will be available here. If you go, if you try to let me add the navigator here to open this. So here I'm gonna call the navigator dot push, and here I'm gonna provide the material app. It will need an instance of the material app route. So material page route, sorry, material page route. So it takes the builder. The builder will be anonymous function that take a context and return an instance of the second screen called second. So if you try to run now or restart the app, so this is our app. When you click this, it will be incremented here in 3 places. Places here and inside the app bar. When you click here, we also need to show the result here, inside here, and inside here. This is our task. You can do this, and we will talk about this in the next lecture. Please don't forget to share, subscribe, and leave a comment.